vinyl friends and vinyl community. It's Brian from Brian's Vinyl Records, and today I'm here to talk to you about an upgrade that I made to my cleaning system. Now, if you've seen my video from a while back, I did show you that I used what I used before, and that was always the Spin Clean. I've been using this for a few years now, and I absolutely love it. I think it's a phenomenal product. It does a great job of cleaning my records, new, used, all of them, and getting rid of some of that grime and grit that are on the records and making them sound better. I have nothing but good things to say about the Spin Clean. I have two of them, one I use to wash and one I use to rinse with, and it's done me really well over the years. But I decided that my collection has gotten pretty large, and I have picked up a bunch of stuff from friends who had stuff sitting in basements and whatnot. And some of that stuff wasn't very well kept, and so there's a lot of dirt and grime on it, and Spin Clean does a great job of making them listenable again. But I thought maybe it was time to try something new, to upgrade my cleaning system and give something else a shot. After many people have posted in many of the vinyl groups that I'm in, different solutions, different thoughts on cleaning, a lot of people who have larger collections said it's almost essential to now upgrade to an ultrasonic cleaner. So I've been mulling this over for quite some time, looking at different ones. There's so many options out there. All-in-one systems like the Degritter and the Humming Guru. There's, you know, put it yourself together systems and all that, and just lots of options. So it was hard to make a choice on what was the best option for me. Talked to a few people I know in the vinyl community. They told me what they do and recommended highly to go this route. So this is what I ended up with. This is my ultrasonic cleaner. This one in particular was created by a company called Hi-Hone. And then I also bought the add-on unit for the vinyl. The add-on unit came with four pucks that allows you to clean up to three albums at a time. You can add another couple pucks onto that unit and up yours to about four, five, or six albums at a time. But I like what I have right now. I may in the future invest in a couple more pucks to make it worthwhile. But for now, I'm just going to leave it as is. Three at a time is pretty good. It gives a good distance between them to feel like it's working well. So, skeptical at first, I thought, okay, well, I'm gonna plunge into this world and see what it does for me. And I will show you in the video, the unit in action. I will show you an album that I'm going to clean that has some surface noise or anything like that. And then I'll show you what the result is afterwards, because I think you're gonna be blown away by what happens here. I know I was. So let's talk about the spin of the unit itself. Real simple. There's only a few things that you need. The first thing you're gonna need is some distilled water. This one comes from Target. You can get these, they're 1 gallon jugs for 99 cents. Stock up on them because it does take a lot of distilled water to clean the albums. After that, you'll need a cleaning agent. I like the Spin Clean solution, so I keep using it. A capful of the Spin Clean solution is plenty enough to pump into that water and get your albums cleaned. Also recommended is 70% isopropyl alcohol, just a small amount of that, maybe a capful in there as well. That helps get the cleaning going. And then you'll want to get a surfactant or a wetting agent. This is the one that was recommended to me, and this is the one I used, and it works great. You can get these at Amazon, and it's fairly decent price, no big deal. So those are the things that you're going to need. Again, a capful of this, a capful of cleaning solution of your choice. I use a Spin Clean solution. And then a capful of isopropyl alcohol. 70% is the recommended amount. No higher, and no, you know, you can go a little lower, but no, really no higher. 70% is the one that they recommend, okay? So you'll put all of that into this unit, and then you'll put your records onto the record portion of it. You'll turn it on, it'll start spinning, and then you'll turn on the unit itself. You set it for 30 degrees Celsius, and they recommend 15 minutes. The people I talked to recommended longer. They said 30 minutes, no more than 30 minutes. That'll get it really nice and clean. So since the beginning, I've been doing 30 minutes at a time. So you're looking at 30 minutes of cleaning per record, per three records, I should say, 1 to 3 records at a time. And then after they're done, I would take them off and put them in a drying rack and let them air dry for 5 to 10 minutes. And then after that, I would take them, put them on my old turntable and hit them with the vinyl vac to get any remaining solution, water, or grit that's on the record out of there. This works great. I highly recommend the vinyl vac. It's awesome. You hook it up to a shop vac and just go. It's great. So I would dry that way. You can let them air dry. For me, I didn't want to because I didn't know if there'd be any like leftover residue from the wetting agent or anything else. So to me, I like to let it air dry a little bit and then clean up the rest with the vinyl vac. So that's how I've been doing it. The results, I gotta say, are absolutely fantastic. I'm super thrilled. I took a couple albums that I got recently. You've seen them in my vinyl editions videos. I picked up 2 big grails for me, the Pistol Annie's Annie Up, and I picked up the Firehouse self-titled album. Now, the Pistol Annie's came to me. It looked beautiful upon inspection. Put it on the turntable, and it had this just noise that was driving me crazy. And I was really upset about that, but I was happy to have the album because it's really difficult to find. So I put it through the spin clean and it fixed a little bit. There was still that surface noise. You can still hear it. And I was just destined to deal with it for the rest of the time that I had the album. It didn't hurt from listening and enjoying the album. It just was one of those distractions in between songs or at low points where you'd hear that crackles and the surface noise. Well, I put it through this ultrasonic cleaner and this baby sounds completely brand new. There's no more surface noise. There's no more loud crackles, pops, anything. The album sounds wonderful and I couldn't be happier about it. Same goes for the Firehouse. It came and had a little bit of surface noise, not a ton. Not enough to drive me nuts anyway. I cleaned it with the spin clean, sounds great. I put it through the ultrasonic cleaner and again, it sounds like it's brand new. I have been so impressed. Now, it's not a miracle worker. It's not going to fix everything. If you have a lot of marks on your disc, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. But if it's just dirty and gritty and old, this thing's going to clean it way better than anything I've used in the past has ever done. And it's going to make a lot of those records pop, sound great. I mean, the fidelity almost improves. I swear it improves upon cleaning through the ultrasonic cleaner. I'm super happy with it. So, without further ado, let me show you this ultrasonic cleaner in action. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play a record here. This is Queensryche's Rage for Order that has a little bit of surface noise on it and that we're gonna try and get out with our new ultrasonic cleaner. We're going to give this Queensryche, the Warning album, a little cleaning. This is going to be getting rid of some of the surface noise, so take a listen to what we have currently. And this last one we have is Richie Blackmore's Rainbow. This one only has a very slight amount of surface noise, but we're going to try and get rid of it. Let's take a listen. We'll be right back. Okay, as you can see, everything's in here, the water's in here. I want the level to be just about to the point where the runout starts. That way it gets there. It's gonna, you know, hit above the runout because of the ultrasonic waves, but just about there should be good. You can see I've got it rotating now, so it's picking up some of that water. And then when I turn it on, you're gonna hear this really nasty, loud, obnoxious noise. And that's what you hear for 30 minutes. So, highly recommend that you put it somewhere you're not gonna get bugged by it, because it is an annoying sound. All right, so here we go. We're gonna get ready to start this. It'll go for 30 minutes at 30 degrees Celsius. Some people like to warm up the tank right away. Right now my tank is sitting at 16 degrees Celsius and it's starting to warm up as we sit here and talk. But we're gonna get this going. 30 minutes, 30 degrees Celsius, and then we'll dry and I'll show you the results.
So as you hear, that's a really noxious noise. You can see inside here, the ultrasonic waves push that together. So now it's mixing the solution, the wetting agent, and all that water together so that it forms this nice cleaning agent here that's going to get all over the record, and the ultrasonic waves are going to hit it and get the dirt and grime out of there. So that's what it's doing right now. It's kind of fun to just sit and look at that as it works its way there. Pretty cool. All right, we'll let this go, and I'll be back when it's done and dried, and I'll show you the result of what we got.
Okay, let's see how this turned out. So this is first one is Rage for Order. This one has a lot of like scuffs and stuff on it, so I'm just hoping we got a nice clean sound at the beginning. So there you have it. I think the results speak for themselves. Now, Rage for Order, like I said, has a lot of scuffs and stuff on it, so I wasn't expecting a ton of really good come out of it, but I thought it sounded better than it did at first. The other two were spotless clean at the beginning. You heard lots of noise in there when I played it the first time, and after cleaning, that noise is completely gone. That happens throughout the whole album, man, and it sounds great. And I've had all the luck in the world. Like I said, it's not a miracle worker. If your album is scratched up and scuffed and anything like that, it's gonna be hard to get rid of that stuff. But if it's just stuff, that noise, it looks beautiful, it looks VG Plus, and you put it on and it has some noise, it's just dirt and stuff that's still stuck within those grooves, and this thing gets it out. So I'm super happy with the ultrasonic cleaner. I think if you were to get it, you would be too. Like I said, there's a ton of options. I'm gonna leave links to what I purchased down below in the description of this video. So if you're interested, you can check that out. Overall, I think with the suffocant, the tank, and the mechanics for the vinyl, everything came out to under $300. And I think that's a heck of a deal. Now, you'll wanna have some sort of way you dry. Use the same method you do now, will work just fine. I use the vinyl vac personally. I think it's a phenomenal product and highly recommend it. You can go out and get one of those. You can create one yourself, whatever you want to do. But I think that's one way to go. Otherwise, a lot of people just like to let it air dry, and that's perfectly fine too. Or use a nice microfiber cloth to clean off the excess wetness when it comes out. That's all up to you. However you want to dry them is up to you. There are units that are out there that will do you know, the drying for you, but they're typically one record at a time. And I like the fact that this one will allow me to clean three records at once. So then I just have to dry them and we're good to go. So there you go. That's my look at my new cleaning setup with the ultrasonic cleaner. Highly recommended. Like I said, I'll leave links below to the units that I purchased. I'll also leave a couple links to some of the other units that are out there for you to look at as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it informative. I hope you found it entertaining. And if so, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Love to hear from you. If you are new, hit the subscribe button. Love to have you along for the ride. Thanks for watching. Until next time, keep spinning, vinyl friends.